So partial matching is a handy tool, which can often save you a lot of typing at the command line. It's not particularly useful when you're writing out programs and functions, but it's very useful when you're kind of working at the command line, typing things as fast as you can. So the idea with partial matching is that it works with the double bracket and the dollar sign operator. So suppose I have a list X which has an element in it called aardvark, which is a sequence 1 through 5. And suppose typing out the word aardvark every single time is a bit of a pain. So I'm just going to type the word A. Well, the way the dollar sign works by default is that it looks for a name in this list that matches the letter A. In this case, there's only one element, and so you get the word aardvark, and it gives me the object associated with aardvark, which is the sequence 1 through 5. So if I use the double bracket operator, things are a little bit different. So what the double bracket operator expects is that the name that you pass it is going to be an exact match for one of the names in the list. So by default, the double bracket operator doesn't do partial matching like the dollar sign does. So now when I pass x double bracket a, what happens is I get null back because there's no element of the list that has the name a. But there's a second argument that you can pass to the double bracket operator, which is the exact argument. And if you specify that exact equals false, and then when I pass it x double bracket a, it gives me the sequence 1 through 5, because that's the one that matches the letter a the closest.